time, noon. Humphrey, seest thou not, William, that the scorching sun by this time half his daily race has run? The savage thrusts his light canoe to shore and hurries homeward with his fishy store. Suppose we leave a while this stubborn soil to eat our dinner and to rest from toil? William agreed. Yon tree whose purple gum bestows a ready medicine for the sick man's woes, forms with its shadowy boughs a cool retreat to shield us from the noontide's sultry heat. Ah, Humphrey! Now upon old England's shore the weary laborer's morning work is o'er. The woodman now rests from his measured stroke, flings down his axe and sits beneath the oak. Savored with hunger there he eats his food, there drinks the cooling streamlet of the wood. To us no cooling streamlet winds its way, no joy's domestic crown for us the day, the felon's name, the outcast's garb we wear, toil all the day, and all the night the spare. Humphrey, ah, William, laboring up the furrowed ground he used to love, the village clock still sound, rejoice to hear my morning toil was done, and trudge it homewards when the clock went one. 'Twas ere I turn a soldier and a sinner. Pshaw! Curse this whining, let us fall to dinner. William, I too have loved this hour, nor yet forgot each joy domestic of my little cot. For at this hour my wife with watchful care was wont each humbler dainty to prepare. The keenest sauce by hunger was supplied, and my poor children prattled at my side. Methinks I see the old oak table spread, the clean white trencher and the good brown bread, the cheese my daily food which Mary made, for Mary knew full well the housewife's trade. The jug of cider, cider I could make, and then the knives I won them at the wake, another has them now. I toiling here look backward like a child and drop a tear. Humphrey, I love a dismal story, tell me thine, meantime, goodwill, I'll listen as I dine. I to my friend can tell a piteous story when I turned hero, how I purchased glory. William, but Humphrey, sure thou never canst have known the comforts of a little home thine own, a home so snug, so cheerful too as mine. 'Twas always clean, and we could make it fine, for there King Charles's golden rules were seen, and there, God bless him, both the king and queen, the pewter plates are garnished chimney grace so nicely scoured, you might have seen your face, and over all, to frighten thieves, was hung well cleaned, altho but seldom must, my gun. That damn gun! I took it down one morn, a desperate deal of harm they did my corn, our testy squire to love to save the breed. So covey upon covey eat my seed, I marked the mischievous rogues, and took my aim, I furred, they fell, and up the keeper came. That curse morning brought on my undoing, I went to prison and my farm to ruin poor Mary. For her grave the parish paid, no tombstone tells where her cold corpse is laid. My children, my dear boys, Humphrey, come grief is dry, you to your dinner, to my story I. To you, my friend, who happier days have known in each calm comfort of a home your own, this is bad living. I have spent my life in hardest toil and unavailing strife, and here, from forest ambush safe at least to me, this scanty pittance seems a feast. I was a ploughboy once, as free from woes and blithesome as the lark with whom I rose. Each evening at return a meal I found, and, though my bed was hard, my sleep was sound. One Whitsuntide, to go to fair, I dressed like a great bumpkin in my Sunday's best, a primrose posy in my hat I stuck into the revel. Went to try my luck from show to show, from booth to booth I stray, see, stare and wonder all the livelong day. A sergeant to the fair recruiting came, skilled in man-catching to beat up for game. Our booth he entered and sat down by me. Methinks even now the very scene I see. The canvas roof, the hogshead's running store, the old blind fiddler seated next the door, the frothy tankard passing to and fro, and the rude drabble round the puppet show. The sergeant eyed me while the punch bowl comes, and as we laughed and drank, up struck the drums, and now he gives a bumper to his wench, God save the king. And then God damn the French, then tells the story of his last campaign, how many wounded and how many slain, flags flying, cannons roaring, drums a beating, the English marching on, the French retreating, push on my lads, they fly before ye, march on to riches, happiness and glory. At first I wondered, by degrees grew bolder, then cried 'tis a fine thing to be a soldier. I, Humphrey, says the sergeant, that's your name? 'Tis a fine thing to fight the French for fame. March to the field, knock out a mounseer's brains, and pick the scoundrel's pocket for your pains. Come, Humphrey, come. Thou art a lad of spirit. Rise to a halbert as I did by merit. Wouldst thou believe it? Even I was once as thou art now, a ploughboy and a dunce, but courage raised me to my rank. How now, boy? Shall hero Humphrey still be numps the ploughboy? A proper-shaped young fellow. Tall and straight. Why, thou wert made for glory. 5'8". The road to riches is the field of fight. Didst ever see a guinea look so bright? Why, regimental snumps would give thee grace, a hat and feather would become that face, the girls would crowd around thee to be kissed. Dost love a girl? Oh, zounds! I cried, I'll list. So passed the night, anon the morning came, and off I set a volunteer for fame. Back shoulders, turn out your toes, hold up your head, stand easy. So I did till almost dead. Oh, how I longed to tend the plow again, trudge up the field and whistle o'er the plain, when tired and sore amid the piteous throng, hungry and cold and wet I limped along, and growing fainter as I passed and colder, curs that ill hour when I became a soldier in town I found the hours more gaily pass and time fled swiftly with my girl and glass. The girls were wondrous kind and wondrous fair, they soon transferred me to the doctor's care, the doctor undertook to cure the evil, and he almost transferred me to the devil. Doctor A. Tedious to relate the dismal story of fighting, fasting, wretchedness and glory. At last discharged, to England's shores I came, paid for my wounds with want instead of fame, found my fair friends and plundered as they bade me, they kissed me, coaxed me, robbed me and betrayed me, tried and condemned his majesty transports me, and here in peace, I thank him, he supports me, so ends my dismal and heroic story, and Humphrey gets more good from guilt than glory.